Hi, this is Dr. Brian Burton. Today we're going to look at how to use Unity to create a Let's Play cinematic that can be put as a Unity Shorts. So let's get started. I'm going to use Unity's new Lego micro game to create this cinematic, but of course you could use your game that you're creating, and that is really the best situation, is to use this to help advertise your game that you're creating. So I've selected Lego micro game. This is a free download with any of the newer Unity versions. I'm using Unity 2019.4 for this particular example. So I've named my project Lego Cinematic, and I'm going to create that. It'll ask you to verify your age and agree to its terms of condition. And then we'll need to wait a few minutes while Unity sets up the project and gets everything ready to go. So I'm going to pause this while it does everything. Okay, so we're ready to go, but before we get too far, make sure you hit that subscribe button, because we're doing all kinds of cool things with this channel on cinematics and multiplayer game development, doing 3D modeling with Blender. So make sure you hit that subscribe button to get all the latest updates that are coming from our channel. Okay, I'm going to select load the playground, and it does start out looking at it, so we need to slide over here a little bit. And there it is. We can just zoom it right over here. You can use WASD to move in and mouse to pan around. There's my pizza guy. And this is the scene we're going to work with for creating our shorts. To get it launched, you can hit the play button and see everything that's happening inside that environment, and it'll look great. Okay, so we got to do a couple things to get ready before we can actually start the recording. The first is we want to change the camera view so that everything looks right. So click up here where it says 16:9, and we're going to open that area and go down here to the bottom where we got the plus key. Click on the plus, and we're going to create a new view. So I'm going to call this shorts, and we need to set the width and height to the view that we want the camera to have inside the game. So that's going to be 1080x1920. Normally we see a view 1920x1080, but this will be 1080x1920, which is standard for a shorts. So once you've got that entered, just click on the OK, and there it is. So now, and you can see my view's already changed to the new shorts format, so we're ready to go on that. So the next thing that we need to do, and it's really just one more thing, we're going to go up here to Window and select the Package Manager, and we need to go to where it says Advanced, Show Preview Packages, and we need to scroll down here. We're looking for Unity Recorder. It's not here in alphabetical list, but if we go down a little further, there it is, Unity Recorder. So select Unity Recorder, and we need to install that to the game. This will take just a few seconds. And there we go. So we can close our package manager now. It's installed, ready to go. If we go back up here to Window, to General, and then Recorder, we'll see the Recorder window, and that's how we're going to get everything set up. So let's get our recorder set up to record this scene. So go click on Add Recorder, select Movie, and go over here, and we're going to change from this window setting, and we need to set it the same as what we just did, the 1080x1920. This will take care of our output resolution so that everything will look exactly like we want for a YouTube Shorts. Make sure you've got End Play Mode clicked, and then we can hit the Start Recorder. And that, there we go. You should hear sounds now from your game playing. It is recording the audio as well. And we're ready to start our shorts. Now we can use the WSA key and the space bar to move around in this environment. And everything that we're doing right now is being recorded for the shorts. You can use the mouse, of course, to look around inside the environment. There, let's run up here. Do a little jumping, and then let's jump on the platform and do a look around. And this is going to be a great show off for the game that we're creating. Of course, I didn't create this. This is Legos. They get all the credit for this. Okay, we got that recorded. That has now been created. And if we go over here to our folder, this will be in our project folder. I've got this stored down here on a different drive. Go over here to my Unity projects. And then here's my Lego cinematic that I created. And there it is, recordings. And there's my recording. Let me pull this over. Yes, here it is running. As you can see, the whole thing was a little over 30 seconds long, which is perfect since shorts have to be less than 60 seconds in length. And it should kick in here. Yeah, there's my running around inside the environment. I'm going to run around a little bit more. I may go ahead and run around a little more before I post this to a short. And yeah, that's enough of that. Okay, so remembering here on your recorder, you can look at some other settings on this. We default to MP4, which is what YouTube really likes. We can, it is of course naturally pulling everything from the game view, and we do have it selected to capture the include the audio from the game itself in the what's being recorded. So this is a high quality record. We can always change that in whatever your editing software is if you want to tweak that a little bit. But all in all, I think we've got this done. Oh, and we did record in 30 frames per second. Most game engines or games are running at 60 frames per second or even higher on modern systems. So recording this at 30 frames per second really keeps your demand on your computer system pretty low. So there we have it. We've got all the basics covered, and we've got a nice short let's play from the game in Unity. So nice easy way to do a promotional video for whatever it is that you're creating and get that on the YouTube shorts, and some nice easy promotion for whatever it is that you're creating. Special thanks to the Unity for creating this and having this great Lego tool set for people to play with. Make sure you do read the terms and conditions. Okay, make sure you hit the subscribe and like to keep up with what else we're doing. Like I said earlier, we've got all kinds of great tutorials coming on 3D modeling, game design, VR, as well as doing cinematics with game engines. Take care.